Very good morning, children. Once again, I welcome you all for my biology YouTube session. This is your Hema Malini, a biology teacher, starting this YouTube session. We'll start this YouTube session with a word of prayer. Let's request you all to join for the word of prayer. Let's pray. Our most gracious Father, we thank you for this wonderful day you have added in our life. Lord, we thank you for this blessed day, blessed morning. Thank you for all your gracious blessing upon us. Lord, we are going to start our YouTube session. Be with us and guide us throughout this YouTube session. We ask these few mercies in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Yes, children, we'll get started. This is the lesson number one, the science of life. And we started the lesson with characteristics of living beings. Already we learned six characters of living beings. And now we are going to discuss about the three characteristics of living beings in this YouTube video. As we learned, living beings can grow, living beings can respond to stimuli, living beings move, living beings are made up of cells, living beings can need food, living beings need food. In that, we learned two important points called autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotrophs are nothing but plants. The organism which can manufacture their own food is called autotrophs. Whereas heterotrophs, organism which depend on other organism for food is called heterotrophs. Next, we learned about excretion. The throwing out of waste from our body is called excretion. And next, we learned respond to stimuli. If you are responding to that, it is called sensitivity. When any organism is responding to stimuli, it is called sensitivity. And next we learnt about respiration. Taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide along with the waste products of carbon dioxide and water. And energy is released during this process. This process is called respiration. And we learnt all these things in the previous class and in the previous YouTube videos. Now in this YouTube video, we are going to start our YouTube session with the characteristics of living beings. In that, the subunit is living beings can move. As we said, animals can move the different parts of the body and they move from one place to another place in search of food and shelter. Animals are called locomotives. These are called locomotive organisms. Animals will move from one place to another place but they are limbs. We move with our legs. Okay. Now, moving from one place to another place is called locomotion. Moving from one place to another place is called locomotion. Okay, define locomotion. You have to write this answer. Moving from one place to another place is called locomotion. Plants too show locomotion. Plants too show movement. They will not move from one place to another place directly, but somehow there will be, you can see a movement. What all the movement? When a plant is it has got a weak stem, it starts climbing on a supportive objects. That is also called as a movement. This weak plant climbs on the supportive object is called, it is a movement. As you plant seedlings, the seedlings will move towards the light. This is also called as a movement in the world, movement in the plant structure. Non-living things also will move. How they will move? A movement in the car, bike, aeroplane, train, ship. All these things will be a movement of a non-living things. For this movement, we need an external force. We need an external force or external energy is needed in the movement of a non-living things. So, the living thing movement is done by its own. Whereas, a non-living thing movement, we need an external force or external energy. So, we have to term it as living beings can move and non-living things cannot move. This is the differentiation. Next one is what we are going to see is about living beings reproduce. Living beings reproduce. living beings reproduce. As we all know that living beings reproduce to for next generation. As we have learned that we came from our father and mother, and father and mother came from grandfather and grandmother. Like that, we need generations to generation. It happens only when an animal or an organism reproduce, the generations are formed. Now we can see some animals will lay eggs. Okay. Some animals will lay eggs and they will bring their offsprings. Offsprings means nothing but young ones. Some animals will lay eggs. Okay. In that, you can see a penguins will lay eggs, and they snakes, birds, mainly birds will lay eggs, and some reptiles. You can see snakes will come under reptiles. They all the reptiles will lay eggs. Crocodile, turtles, lizards, garden lizards, all these things comes under reptile category. So they all will lay eggs. All these living beings will lay eggs. Next thing is birds. Birds lay eggs and they get their young ones. A well known example is a hen. Hen lay eggs. This is a reproductive system, reproduction in the human beings and in the animals. Okay, not in human beings, it is in the animals which lay eggs. Where some animals give birth to their young ones. Some animals give birth to their young ones. Example, as you know, from the childhood you are learning the names of young ones. Lion and cub, sheep and lamb, horse and bull, mare and colt, goat and kid. All these are the young ones. They give direct birth to the young ones. As we all, the human beings also are giving birth to their young ones. Okay, these are the examples for animals which give the birth to young ones. How do plants grow from the seed? The plants also will reproduce. The plants reproduce by the they start germinating from a seed. This is how a plant gets germinated from a seed. They reproduce. How they reproduce? A seed is there. A seed grows into a root system and shoot system, and then they grow into a small plant, and then they'll grow into a very big plant, and they grow into a tree, and the trees will give flowers, and the flowers will be turned into a fruit, and that fruit you will be having seeds, and the seeds get dried up and they fall on the ground. Again the seed will grow into plants, shoot system and root system, and again it will germinate into a small plant into a big plant into a tree. Tree gives to the flower, flower in turn goes to a fruit and turns into a fruit, and fruits you have the seeds. This is the reproductive system, reproduction cycle in a plant system. Okay, now apart from this, there are some plants which will grow from the stem without the seeds. Some plants will grow from the mother plant. For example, if you cut the stem from the mother plant and plant it, it will germinate. Okay, it will germinate. If you keep only one stem in the ground, it starts growing into a, it germinates. There are many examples for that also. From a mother plant, directly if you cut a stem and plant it, it will grow into a new plant. Next characteristic, last characteristics, which tells about the characteristics of living being is nothing but living beings. The last thing is the living beings follow a definite life cycle. What is a life cycle? A cycle which follows, a living being follow a cycle which starts with the birth, growth, reproducing, aging and death. As you know very well, it is all known to you. You will be very small as soon you were born. That is called infant period. Infants, very small baby. Okay, then you will be growing it into 1 or 2 years, you will become a baby. And again that you will become, after growing, what after the days goes off, after the months or the after years pass away, what you will be? you'll grow into a boy. Again, if you are growing after years together, how you'll be? You'll be like a tall boys, tall big boys, adolescent period. You'll be in the adolescent period. And after that, you'll get matured and you'll be reaching your adulthood period. After adolescent, you'll be reaching your adulthood period. And the adulthood period, I'd like to show you one picture. I'll show you one picture. I'll show you in the Zoom class, okay? That time I'll show you. I'll start. As soon as you are born, you will be in an infant stage. As months and days go pass away, as the days and months pass away, you'll be growing into a baby. 6 months baby, 7 months baby. As the days pass on, as the months pass on, as the years goes off, you'll be growing into a boy or a girl, small boy or a girl. As the years rolls on, you'll be growing into a boys, big boys and big girls. You'll be reaching your adolescent period. After that, you'll be growing and you'll be reaching a adulthood. At that adulthood, you'll be very big and very strong enough. That time, you'll be like a man and a woman. And then, you'll be getting into a family. Then, you'll be giving birth to a small baby. After you're giving your family is formed, again the years will go on. You'll be becoming aged. You'll go into a next stage called old age. Not old age. Before old age. And then after the years goes on, you'll become very weak. And you'll become very old. And you will come to a very old stage called old age or end part of our life. And we get, and the last thing is death. After a certain period, after getting aged up, we'll be reaching the death. This is a cycle which is formed in the every human being. All the human beings will follow this type of cycle is seen in all the human beings and all the living organisms. The time between, there is an important definition here. There is one definition called lifespan, the very important definition. The lifetime, the lifespan, this is a very important definition. The definition goes like this. The time between birth and death is called lifespan. The time between birth and the death is called lifespan. As soon as you start your birth, and the day it ends, the time between this is called as lifespan. For example, bacteria will live for only 20 minutes. The lifespan of a bacteria is 20 minutes. Whereas the lifespan for a dog is 16 to 17 years maximum, sometimes 12 years. The lifespan of a butterfly will be 1 or 2 days. Lifespan of a human being is up to 70 to 80 years. This is the lifespan or the years how long you are going to live. A very simple definition, but it will be a very important definition. Make a note of it. The time between birth and death is called lifespan. Yes, children. And this is the end of lesson number 1. Okay. This is the end of lesson number 1. We'll revise what we learnt from the beginning. One more time, I'll give a speed recollection. We'll recollect it. The first characteristics we learned is living beings are made up of cells. Second thing is living beings need food. Third one is living beings respire. Third one is living being respire. Fourth one is living beings throw out waste. Fifth one is living being responds to a stimuli. Sixth one is living beings reproduce. Seventh one is living beings can move. Last one is living beings can reproduce. And the eighth one is living beings can reproduce. And the last one is living beings will follow a definite life cycle. These are the important characteristics which are seen in the living beings. Up to this, the first lesson gets over. After this, what you have to do? All your book back exercises will be given to you. All your book back exercises will be given to you in a PDF format. Okay. All the book back exercises will be given in your PDF format, and it will be posted in your WhatsApp. Okay, children, you can make a note of it. You can use it when in exams are given. Before, if you have book, kindly write in your book. Kindly copy down all the answers in your book. After posting it, the immediate work what you have to do is copy down the answer in your book. First thing. Second thing, if you are not having a book, try to get a book from the school. The third thing is prepare yourself for test. These are the three important things. If the thing is posted, copy down the answers in your book, try to get the book and start preparing for your examination. Last but not least, try to complete all your classwork. Try to complete all your classwork. The only one thing is left over, brief answer is left over, that will also be typed and posted to you. Copy down all the question answer in your classwork notebook. In your classwork notebook, you will be writing new words, short answers and detail answers. These three things you will be writing in your classwork. Apart from that, any diagrams are given to you, you will be drawing the diagrams. These are the main instructions what I want to give you in this YouTube video, and I completed all my instructions. We'll end this YouTube session with a word of prayer. Yes, we'll close this YouTube video with a word of prayer. Our most gracious, loving Father in heaven, we thank you for this YouTube video. Lord, we completed one lesson, the science of life. Thank you for this life which has given to us. Lord, we specially thank our parents who gave birth to us, who took care of us, who protected us, who are guiding us. Lord, we thank you for holding us. We thank for our school members and our teachers for teaching through online session. Lord, we specially thank for your presence. We thank you, God, for holding us and guiding us throughout these many days, throughout these days, through these many struggles. Lord, we specially thank for our parents for protecting us. We pray for our parents at this moment. Give them good health and strength. We ask these few mercies in your precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, children. Once again, I'll meet you in the next YouTube session. Until then, it's bye from your Hemamalini teacher, signing off from you. Thank you. We'll meet again.